Hi there. If you're new here, welcome. But if you're returning, welcome back. It's great to have you here. Today, I'm going to be talking about finding a string inside a bigger string. Let's go ahead and solve this very, very interesting challenge. So on the screen, I've got the Hackerrank on the left. I've got very small Jupyter notebook on the right that will help me to explain things a bit deeper. In today's task, we are going to find a substring inside a bigger string. I'm going to go ahead and read the task. In this challenge, the user enters a string and a substring. You have to print the number of times that the substring occurs in a given string. String traversal will take place from left to right, not from right to left. So if you can only understand what is happening from left to right, that's enough. Note, string letters are case sensitive. We want to be careful about case sensitivity. Input format. The first line of input contains the original string. The next line contains the substring. So let's look at this. If you've been following my series, you will remember that I call this part the execution part. It's like, you want to make a pizza. Here is your recipe up the top, how to make a pizza. And this is actually taking that recipe and making that pizza. Let's look at the execution part, and then we will go ahead and write the recipe. You receive a string from the user, which is on the input side, then you strip it. Stripping means to get rid of any space before and after, not in the middle. If you want to get rid of the spaces in the middle, you will have to go onto split, not strip. And the second line will give you the substring, and you also strip the substring because you don't want any spaces before and after. You send those two variables into your recipe, which is sitting up here, and then you print the final result. Let's look at the example that is given. Let's imagine this is the string. I'm just going to copy that to my Jupyter notebook. That's my string, and my substring equals CDC, and that's what I have here. So the user gives me these two inputs in red and tells me how many times this happens here. Well, that's very straightforward, but you just need to think about how to do that. The way I think about it, I would say, well, I would love to go through the main string so many times that covers this substring. So this substring has got three values in it. So I would like to say the first three, is it the same? No, ABC doesn't equal CDC, okay? Now, how about BCD, does it equal CDC? No, it doesn't. How about CDC? Yes, that's one. How about DCD? No. How about CDC? Yes, again. So for this very example, my answer should be two. But think about what I just narrated. I said, I would like to get a starting point to start at zero. And I would like to every time have an endpoint. And my endpoint is how big the substring is. So the length of substring here was 3. So if I go from 0 to 3, and remember that in Python we don't include the last one. 0 to 3 means 0, 1, and 2. It doesn't include 3, which is great. It works for me here. And I would also like to make an empty container which holds the count. So it will be like, I'm using my fingers. I'll say, okay, this is 1 and this is 2. I'm using a container for that. I'll start by 0. What I want to do, I want to go over this string 3 by 3 and every time check if that substring equals to those 3. What I can do, I can say while the end that I just made end here and it starts from 3, while the end is less than or equal to the length of the bigger string. So I don't want to go over the length of this. I just want to start from 0 and go to the end of this. While end is smaller or equal to len of string, okay? If substring equals string from start to end, if that's the case, I want you to add one more value into the counter. So counter was 0 in the beginning. Now I will add 1 to it. You might say, well, I don't really understand what this means. Very good question. This is exactly equal to writing counter equals counter plus one. If you want to write this shorter, just get rid of this counter here, get rid of this plus sign here, and put it here. That will do exactly what it would do if you said counter equals counter plus one. So that's something new. And if not, add one to the start and add one to the end. So we want to be able to slide the window, say, go from 0 to 3, go from 1 to 4, go from 2 to 5, 3 to 6, and so forth. So we are sliding that window over that string. Once you have done that, just print the counter and let me see how many I found. Look at that. When I was counting orally, I said, yes, we will have two. And now we actually have two. All right. I think this will be actually my function. What I will do, I will copy that, put it here. Well, when you copy and paste, make sure you are careful about the tab, because if you have a function, you want everything to be four spaces at the front. The last thing I need to do is to return the counter. So this is recipe of the pizza, and this is making the pizza. Let's run it. Great, it worked. So if you're happy that it worked, like my video, subscribe to my channel. Hope to see you soon.